So the lesson that I did was called Layers of the Rainforest. I made it for first grade, and my NGSS standard was 2LS41, which is make observations of plants and animals to compare the diversity of life in different habitats. The cross-cutting concept that I chose for this was systems and system models because it kind of talks about like the ecosystem. And how the different plants and animals can exist within each layers because of the traits and characteristics that they have. My objective was students will be able to identify and name the levels of the rainforest. The materials that I would need were a smart board or some sort of a projector, a link to my presentation, which I have linked in the lesson plan that I uploaded to Blackboard. That's the presentation that I actually would show my students. And the testable question, obviously, this is just the introductory lesson, but the testable question that I would use for this whole unit on the rainforest would be, does the temperature on the emergent layer impact the growth of plants on the understory? So obviously, like I said, this lesson, I just want the students to be able to name the four layers by the end of it. But in the upcoming lessons, we would be talking about specifically each layer and how they impact each other. So my pre-assessment would kind of just be a formative assessment. I would ask my students to hold up how many fingers they think are to represent the number of layers that there are in the rainforest. So I'd say, okay, ready, set, go. Some students might say two, three, four, seven, however many. Then I'm going to do my launch, which is where I would ask the children who knows what a rainforest is and if they know how many layers are in it. I would have, this is when I would be pulling up my slideshow, which again is linked in the thing. And then after I go through the whole presentation, I'm going to sing this song to help the students understand. And I guess I'll sing it for you, even though I'm not a very good singer. So here we go. The emergence home to birds and butterflies, butterflies. The emergence home to birds and butterflies, butterflies. The trees are so high that they almost reach the sky. The emergence home to birds and butterflies. The canopy is like a big umbrella, big umbrella. The canopy is like a big umbrella, big umbrella. Monkeys, sloths, orangutans eat all the fruit they can. The canopy is like a big umbrella. The understory's home to many snakes, many snakes. The understory's home to many snakes, many snakes. They eat cats and bats and rats, and they like the gnats for snacks. The understory's home to many snakes. The forest floor is dim, dark, and wet, dark, and wet. The forest floor is dim, dark, and wet, dark, and wet. Oh, the ants go marching by as they watch the birds up high. The forest floor is dim, dark, and wet. So I think that's a really catchy song that the students would really like, especially for first grade. I actually learned this in my music methods class when I took that a while ago. I did this song in my presentation for that one because we had to connect music with a core area and I loved it, and so I moved that to this lesson as well. Now for my extension activity, I said that I would have different cards all around the room and I would have the students go pick a card, and their card would either have an animal or a plant on it. And then I would have four big tables set up as the four layers, and they would have to go to the table that their animal lives in. So, for example, if the students had a monkey, they would know that they need to go to the canopy table. Then we would play the song again, but they would only sing the section of the song that represents the table that they're at. So, again, if they had the monkey, they're gonna be at the canopy level. So, they're gonna only sing the chunk of the song that talks about the canopy. But they also have to sing and act out their animal or plant. So, like for a monkey, you could do this while you sing. It's kind of just a visual piece to the lesson that I think really does help extend their learning. And then my post-assessment would be I would have an exit slip that would make them name each of the four layers of the rainforest, and it aligns with the objective because it makes them independently list the layers of the rainforest rather than just the number like we did at the beginning. That was the pre-assessment. Now I'm hoping that we can encourage some higher level thinking and have them actually name the levels. Yeah, and then I have my standards 4, 8, 7, and 6 listed at the bottom for you to look at as well. But I hope you enjoyed my lesson. And like I said, my presentation that I would use is linked on my lesson plan.